Hi there. Snipcart allows merchants to handle taxes in many ways. In this video, I'm going to explore this feature in the dashboard and show a few examples of common use cases. First, let's look at the taxes section of the merchant dashboard. Open up the right side menu and click Taxes. To create a new tax, click the Create New Tax button. Let's go over the form. The first field is for the name of the tax. Note that this name will be displayed in the cart and on the invoice. The second field is where you apply the rate of the tax. For a 10% tax, you would enter 0.10, and so on. Then, you can select the location where this tax applies. You can create taxes that will be applied to every order by selecting the worldwide option. Otherwise, you can scope it to a specific country or the combination of a country with a specific province or state. In the advanced options, you'll find included in price. Check this if you want the taxed amount to be already included in your product's prices. More info about this later in this video. The checkbox applies on shipping can be checked if you need to apply taxes on shipping fees as well. The number for invoice field is the business tax number to be displayed on the invoice. This field is optional. The last field named Postal Code Regular Expression allows you to create tax rates that will only be applied on orders in the specific location in which the postal code matches that rejects. Let's go ahead and create a first tax. I'll name it GST. It will have a 10% rate. Save this. And just like that, if I go back to the cart and fill out the billing information, the tax will be added to the summary automatically. Let's see how it works if you want to limit this tax to a specific province or state. In the tax definition, select a country and then a province. Save this. If a customer isn't from the specific province, the tax won't be applied. If I change the address for the province I've specified, the tax is added. Now, what if you have products that are not taxable? We have created an HTML attribute for that. Let's keep going with the GST tax we've already created. Open up your code editor to access your site's codebase. Within your Buy button, add the attribute DataItemTaxable and make its value false. If you then add this specific product to the cart and fill out the billing info, you can see that the GST tax isn't applied. When I created this tax in my dashboard, I let the Applies on Shipping checked, so if I select the $20 shipping method, the GST tax is added to the amount. You could also have products that are exempt from a specific tax. For instance, in our home province of Quebec, books are exempt from the provincial tax, but not the federal one. Let's see how to handle this type of use case with Snipcart. For this example, I have two taxes created in my account. One is GST, a 5% tax rate for Canadian customers, regardless of the province. The second one, the PST, is a 9.9% tax rate for customers located in the province of Quebec. Normally, people from Quebec should pay both taxes, but we'll create a product that is exempt from the PST, the provincial tax. Open up your code editor. Under the selected product, add the data item taxes attribute. You can then specify which taxes apply to this product. Here, multiple taxes can be split by a pipe. In my case, I'll only set the GST tax, since the PST shouldn't be applied to any order containing this product. If we add this product to the cart and fill out the billing info, you can see that only the GST tax is applied, leaving out the PST. If we add any other product that doesn't have any tax exemption to the order, the PST is then added and is calculated only on eligible products. For my last example, I'll explore the case where taxes are included in the product's price. It's a pretty standard approach in Europe. Let's create a new tax called VAT. Let's set it at a rate of 20% and don't forget to check the Included in Price checkbox. Then, you need to define in your HTML that your product's prices include taxes. Open up your code editor. Under the Products Buy button, insert the data item as taxes included attribute and set its value to true. We'll add this product to the cart. After filling out the billing info, you can see in the summary that the tax is calculated correctly and included in the price. That pretty much sums up our tax management feature. If you need 100% control over tax calculation, you can also use our Webhooks API. We also offer integrations with two tax providers to allow automatic sales calculation. To explore these alternatives, head to the Taxes section of our documentation.